great pleasure and joy to welcome you to St. David's Church for the service of ordination. Just a few things which I hope will help the service to run smoothly. Firstly, during a piece, if you could just share the piece physically with those you're in a bubble with, that would be great. When it comes to taking Holy Communion, if you'd like to receive Communion, please just form a single line. I'm coming up the middle of the church, and Bishop Jackie will be distributing the bread from the centre here. And finally, at the end of the service, the candidates are going to go straight outside for some photos. So it'll be an opportunity for you, if you'd like, formal or informal photos, to take those at the end of the service. It's a very special day today. It's a great honour and privilege for us to be here on this ordination day. It's also a special day for Bishop Jackie, as it's her birthday. But she has specifically asked that we don't sing. But you could wish her happy birthday at the end. So now, we'll keep a moment of quietness and then we'll sing the opening hymn, a great hymn of praise. Praise to the Lord, the Almighty, the King of creation.
Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen. one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
Peace be with you.
And also with you.
And my welcome to Diocese here to St. David's for this ordination service. Here in Exeter Diocese, we ordain at Michaelmas, the feast of St. Michael and all angels. And so we rejoice that we are surrounded by the angels and by the great crowd of witnesses, too many to count, who we dare to believe are cheering us on today. Ordinations are days of thanksgiving, and we give thanks to God for the vocation that we all have in Jesus Christ. And we give thanks especially today for Ashley, for Tati, for Vanessa, and for Tracy. In your journey of faith, in your obedience to God's call, and in your willingness to serve and your faithfulness, you call each of us into relationship with God and into the joy of being God's people, and we are grateful. Ash, Patty, Vanessa, and Tracy are ordained as priests today. Thank you to all of you who have been a part of their journey, who have loved and supported them, who have travelled with them. And I want to say, don't think that today is the day of arrival and completion. It is a day of arrival, but the journey continues, and your support and love and prayers are still needed. All of those being ordained over this weekend in various churches across the diocese have been on retreat at Shelter. Very lovely and special time together. And I want to record here my thanks to the Reverend Gordon Crowther. He is the Warden of the Abbey, for leading the retreat so beautifully. And I want to thank the Reverend Prebendary Kim Mathers, who is here to be our preacher for today. Kim is known to many of us, and especially to the curates here for her work in the diocese, but is also a priest in the Sid Valley Mission community. Kim, we look forward to your sermon later. So thank you to all who have made today possible, for Nigel, for your team here, for the Archdeacon and my chaplain. Organising a significant service is not an easy task, and it is much appreciated. And thank you, trainers and all in your churches who love and support, and who I know will receive the ministry of these new priests with joy. As we ordain these four people today, make no mistake that you are being called for now, for this time, for this world, and for your communities, to be servants and shepherds watching for the signs of God, a calling which at this time is needed more than ever. God calls his people to follow Christ and forms us into a royal priesthood, a holy nation, to declare the wonderful deeds of him who has called us out of darkness into his marvellous light. The Church is the body of Christ, the people of God, and the dwelling place of the Holy Spirit. In baptism, the whole Church is summoned to witness to God's love and to work for the coming of his kingdom. To serve this royal priesthood, God has given particular ministries. Priests are ordained to lead God's people in the offering of praise and the proclamation of the gospel. They share with the bishop in the oversight of the church, delighting in its beauty and rejoicing in its well-being. They are to set the example of the Good Shepherd always before them as the pattern of their calling. With the bishop and their fellow presbyters, they are to sustain the community of the faithful by the ministry of word and sacrament, that we all may grow into the fullness of Christ and be a living sacrifice acceptable to God.
Bishop Jackie, I present Ashley Leighton Blom to be ordained to the office of priest in the Church of Ordination. He is to serve in the parish of St. David's with St. Michael and All Angels in Exeter. Bishop Jackie, I present Tatiana Wilson to be ordained to the office of priest in the Church of Ordination. She is to serve in the parish of St. Mark's, Exeter. Bishop Jackie, I present Vanessa Pestridge to be ordained to the office of priest in the Church of God. She is to serve in the parish of St. Matthew's with St. Sidwell. Bishop Jackie, I present Tracy Voisey to be ordained to the office of priest in the Church of God. She is to serve in the parishes of Axminster, All Saints, Axmouth, Chardstock, Columpine, with Roosden, Membry, and Upline.
Have those whose duty it is to know these ordinands and examine them found them to be of godly life and sound learning?
They have.
Do they believe them to be duly called to serve God in this ministry?
They do.
Do you believe that God is calling you to this ministry?
I do so believe.
I invite the Archdeacon to confirm that the ordinands have taken the necessary oaths and made the declaration of assent.
They have duly taken the oath of allegiance to the sovereign and the oath of canonical obedience to the bishop. They have affirmed and declared their belief in the faith which is revealed in the Holy Scriptures and set forth in the Catholic creeds, and to which the historic formalities of the Church of England bear witness.
Be stand
to
give glory to God.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Let us hold a moment of quiet as we continue to pray for Ashley, Tatiana, Vanessa, and Tracy, and for the ministry of the whole people of God. God, our Father, Lord of all the world, through your Son you have called us into the fellowship of your universal Church. Hear our prayer for your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry, each may be an instrument of your love. And give to your servants, now to be ordained, the needful gifts of grace. Through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Do please be seated.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 12, verses 1 to 8. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourselves more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we, who are many, are one body in Christ, and individually we are members one of another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. and curing every disease and every sickness. When he saw the crowds, he had compassion for them, because they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. Therefore ask the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into this harvest." Then Jesus summoned his 12 disciples and gave them authority over unclean spirits, to cast them out and to cure every disease and every sickness. These are the names of the 12 apostles. First, Simon, also known as Peter, and his brother Andrew. James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John. Philip and Bartholomew. Thomas and Matthew the tax collector. James, son of Alphaeus and Thaddeus. Simon the Cananean and Judas Iscariot, the one who betrayed him. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Ordination to the priesthood today. As human beings, we seem to be hardwired to think in threes. Let me show you how this works. I'm going to give you two words, and I can guarantee that most of you will automatically know the third word, because it will pop into your head without you even thinking about it. Let's give it a try. Tom, Dick, and
Harry.
Snap, crackle,
pop.
Red, amber,
green.
Body, mind, and
spirit.
Hands, face.
Space.
Of course, when it comes to sermons, we have the classic three-point sermon with a beginning, a middle, and a
end.
Thank you. But this is not a classic three-point sermon, but there are lots of threes within it, so you may like to see if you can spot them. I begin with a story that involves three characters. Characters created by the cartoonist Charles Schulz, and immortalised in his well-loved Peanuts comic strip. Now, Snoopy is my hero, but this story is about Linus, Lucy, and Charlie Brown. Linus is an optimist with insecurity issues. Lucy is forthright and somewhat sceptical. And Charlie Brown is just, well, just Charlie Brown, down on himself and often disheartened. So Lucy and Linus are sat together. Linus is daydreaming. "When I grow up, I'm going to be a country doctor." Lucy is characteristically sceptical and just wanders off. Later, Linus is sat with Charlie Brown, and he continues his train of thought. "When I get big, I'm going to be a humble little country doctor. I'll live in the city, and every morning I'll get up, climb into my sports car and zoom into the country. Then I'll start healing people. I'll heal everybody for miles around. I'll be a world famous, humble little country doctor. Charlie Brown looks amused. Lucy wanders back and then is characteristically forthright. You could never be a doctor, she tells Linus. You know why? And before Linus has time to reply, she tells him why. Because you don't love mankind. And finding his voice, Linus shouts, I love mankind. It's people I can't stand. Love for people is a quality that we look for in those to be ordained. It's a quality that we hope we would find in all God's people, along with love for God. Ash, Tatty, Vanessa and Tracy, you're about to be ordained priests. You may or may not have daydreamed about being a priest, or even a world famous humble little parish priest.
Guilty.
But you have all responded to God's call. You have undergone a long period of study and training, and dare I say it, formation. And we hope and trust that you love the people with whom you are called to serve, even when that's hard. You are called to a ministry exemplified by the one who travelled through cities and villages, teaching and preaching and healing those described as harassed and helpless, like sheep without a shepherd. His was a threefold ministry. No distance was too great, no audience too sceptical, and no disease too acute. Despite opposition, Jesus got the job done. The 12 disciples were called to be with him, and as apostles they were sent out to continue his work, as we are sent out to continue his work today. Have we got what it takes to get the job done? Benjamin Franklin, a founding father of the United States, and interestingly, inventor of bifocals. Benjamin Franklin famously said, there are three things that are extremely hard. Steel, diamonds, and to know oneself. Arguably, it's useful in ministry to have nerves of steel, and we could perhaps do with a few more rough diamonds. But to know ourselves is absolutely vital in ministry. Someone who knew that only too well was Henry Parry Liddon, Vice Principal of Cudston Theological College in the 1850s. Concerned for the ordinands in his charge, he warned them of the various temptations that they would face in ministry. And he drew particular attention to the love of prominence, the love of popularity, and the love of praise. To know ourselves is to know our frailties and our vulnerabilities, as well as our strengths and our gifts. Our New Testament passage from Romans 12 is a reminder to all of us that we need to keep our egos in check. Do not think of yourselves more highly than you ought to think, writes St. Paul, but think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. Linus started by wanting to be a country doctor, but his ambition grew and grew until he wanted to be not just a country doctor, but a world-famous, humble little country doctor. Whilst it's true that some think too highly of themselves, it is also true that some do not think of themselves highly enough. Some, like Charlie Brown, have great qualities and gifts, but do not recognise that they have an important contribution to make, because somehow they feel like, or they don't fit, or they don't belong, or they aren't good enough. Here, Paul's metaphor of the body to describe the church is encouraging as well as challenging. Every Christian has a part, is a part of the body of Christ. Every Christian has a role to play. And every Christian must play their part. You and I are to be who we were made to be, without being envious of others, and without pridefully or unfavourably comparing ourselves with others. You and I serve in the body of Christ as who we are, and not how we or others would like us to be. You are not supposed to serve like others. You are supposed to serve like you. It's true for each one of us as part of the body of Christ. And it is equally true for Tracy and Vanessa and Tati and Ash. You are supposed to serve not like others. You are supposed to serve like you. Priests are called with their bishop and fellow priests to sustain the community of the faithful by a ministry of word and sacrament. And that is a great privilege. This week I have witnessed the sustaining ministry of the sacrament. A person emotionally bruised and hurting received deep inner healing and peace. You have stopped the bleeding, was the arresting way in which she described her experience, an elderly, faithful community. Here is priestly ministry, sustaining the community of the faithful, but only by the grace and the power of God. And priests are called to this ministry so that all of us will grow in the fullness of Christ to be a living sacrifice acceptable to God. The words of our liturgy, our service, echoing the opening words of Romans chapter 12. What does it mean to be a living sacrifice acceptable to God? Well, St. Paul is drawing on imagery about what he knew about Old Testament sacrifices. People of God in Old Testament times expressed their worship to God by presenting an animal to be sacrificed in the temple. Under Old Testament law, the animal had to be alive, completely without blemish, a perfect specimen for God. Put it into Old Testament shorthand, as Paul does here, it had to be holy, and only then was it acceptable to God. And Romans 12, Paul is talking about Christian worship, about what he calls spiritual or intelligent, reasonable worship. And the spiritual worship he is asking us to give is our bodies, not just our minds, not just our hearts, not just our words, but our whole bodies, our whole selves. And these bodies are to have the same qualities as Old Testament sacrifices. It must be presented alive and must be holy. It's no good waiting until we're dead and then offering ourselves to God. William Booth, the founder of the Church Army, was once asked near the end of his life why his life had been so effective in the work of ministry. And he replied, "God had all there was of me. There have been others who had greater plans, greater opportunities than I. But from the day I got a vision of what God could do, I made up my mind God would have all there was of William Booth." God chooses the Linuses, the Lucys, and the Charlie Browns of this world. He calls us with all our vulnerabilities, with all our foibles, and he equips and empowers us so that we can play our part in the body of Christ, Church. So one final three: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Love God, love people. God took a body and came to earth. Then in love offered it up in every part for us. We are called to give all of ourselves to God because God in Christ gave all of himself for us.
Sisters and brothers, I ask you to profess together with those to be ordained priests in the faith of the Church.
We believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made, for us and for our salvation.
are called to be servants and shepherds among the people to whom they are sent. With their bishop and fellow ministers, they are to proclaim the word of the Lord and stewards of the Lord. They are to teach and to admonish, to feed and provide for his family, to search for his children in the wilderness of this world's temptations, and to guide them through its confusions, that they may be saved through Christ forever. Formed by the word, they are to call their hearers to repentance and to declare in Christ's name the absolution and forgiveness of their sins. With all God's people, they are to tell the story of God's love. They are to baptize new disciples in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and to walk with them in the way of Christ, nurturing them in the faith. They are to unfold the scriptures, to preach the word in season and out of season, and to declare the mighty acts of God. They are to preside at the Lord's table and lead his people in worship, offering with them a spiritual sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. They are to bless the people in God's name. They are to resist evil, support the weak, defend the poor, and intercede for all in need. They are to minister to the sick and prepare the dying for their death. Guided by the Spirit, they are to discern and foster the gifts of all God's people, that the whole church may be built up in unity and faith. We trust that long ago you began to weigh and ponder all of this, and that you are fully determined by the grace of God to devote yourself wholly to his service, so that as you daily follow the rule and teaching of our Lord and grow into his likeness, God may sanctify the lives of all with whom you have to do. And now, in order that we may know your mind and purpose, you must make the declarations we put to you. Do you accept the Holy Scriptures as revealing all things necessary for eternal salvation through faith in Jesus Christ?
I do so accept.
Will you be diligent in prayer, in reading Holy Scripture, and in all studies that will deepen your faith and fit you to bear witness to the truth of the gospel?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you lead Christ's people in proclaiming his glorious gospel, so that the good news of salvation may be heard in every place?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you faithfully minister the doctrine and sacraments of Christ as the Church of England has received them, so that the people committed to your charge may be defended against error and flourish in the faith?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you, knowing yourself to be reconciled to God in Christ, strive to be an instrument of God's peace in the church and in the world?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you endeavour to fashion your own life and that of your household according to the way of Christ, that you may be a pattern and example to Christ's people?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you work with your fellow servants in the gospel for the sake of the kingdom of God?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you accept and minister the discipline of this church and respect authority duly exercised within it?
By the help of God, I will.
Will you then, in the strength of the Holy Spirit, continually stir up the gift of God that is in you to make Christ known among all whom you serve?
By the help of God, I will.
Would you like to stand? I'm looking for some very confident responses. Brothers and sisters, you have heard how great is the charge that these ordinands are ready to undertake, and you have heard their declarations. Is it now your will that they should be ordained?
It is.
Will you continually pray for them?
We will.
Will you uphold and encourage them in their ministry?
We will.
In the name of our Lord, we bid you remember the greatness of the trust that is now to be committed to your charge. Remember always with thanksgiving that the treasure now to be entrusted to you is Christ's own flock, brought by the shedding of his blood on the cross. It is to him that you will render account for your stewardship of his people. You cannot bear the weight of this calling in your own strength, but only by the grace and power of God. Pray, therefore, that your hearts may daily be enlarged and your understanding of the Scriptures enlightened. Pray earnestly for the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Spirit, and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all the members of the Church in their vocation and ministry, that they may serve him in truth and love.
let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Robert, Jackie and Nick, our bishops, and for all bishops, presbyters and deacons, that they may hunger for truth and thirst after righteousness, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Ashley, Tatiana, Vanessa and Tracy, called to be priests in his church, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the mission of the church, that in faithful witness we may proclaim the gospel of reconciliation to the ends of the earth, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the unity of the church, that we may be one in Christ according to his will, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For those who are lost, and for those who have strayed, that they may return to the way of Christ, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the sick and suffering, for the aged and infirm, for the lonely and neglected, and for all who remember and care for them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the poor and the hungry, for the homeless and the oppressed, for all prisoners and captives, and for our brothers and sisters who are persecuted for their faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Elizabeth, our Queen, for the leaders of the nations, and for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For ourselves, for grace to repent and amend our lives, that we may be pardoned and absolved from all our sins, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Remembering all who have gone before us in faith, and in communion with David, Michael, Peter, Mary, and all the saints, we commit ourselves, one another, and our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
Those who are going to be laying on hands, please come and stand close by. We praise and glorify you, Almighty Father, because in your infinite love you have formed throughout the world a holy people for your own possession, a royal priesthood, a universal church. We praise and glorify you because you have given us your only Son, Jesus Christ, the image of your eternal and invisible glory, the firstborn of all creation, and head of the church. We praise and glorify you that by his death he has overcome them, and that having ascended into heaven, he has given his gifts abundantly to equip your holy people for the work of ministry, for the building up of the body of Christ. And now we give you thanks that you have called these your servants, whom we ordain in your name, to share as priests in the ministry of the gospel of Christ, the apostle and high priest of our faith, and the shepherd of our souls. Therefore, Father, through Christ our Lord, we pray. Send down the Holy Spirit upon your servant Ashley for the office and work of a priest in your church. Send down the Holy Spirit on your servant Tatiana for the office and work of a priest in your church. Send down the Holy Spirit on your servant Vanessa for the office and work of a priest in your church. Send down the Holy Spirit upon your servant Tracy for the office and work of a priest in your church. Through your Spirit, Heavenly Father, give these, your servants, grace and power to proclaim the gospel of your salvation and minister the sacraments of the new covenant. Renew them in holiness and give them wisdom and discipline to work faithfully with those committed to their charge. In union with their fellow servants in Christ, may they reconcile what is divided, heal what is wounded, and restore what is lost. May they declare your blessings to your people. May they proclaim Christ's victory over the powers of darkness and absolve in Christ's name those who turn to him in faith. So shall people made whole in Christ offer spiritual sacrifices acceptable to you, our God and Father, to whom with the Son and the Holy Spirit belong glory and honour, worship and praise, now and forever. Amen. May God, who anointed the Christ with the Holy Spirit at his baptism, anoint and empower you to reconcile and bless his people. Tatiana. May God, who anointed the Christ with the Holy Spirit at his baptism, anoint and empower you to reconcile and bless his people. Blessed may God, who anointed the Christ with the Holy Spirit at his baptism, anoint and empower you to reconcile and bless his people. May God, who anointed the Christ with the Holy Spirit at his baptism, anoint and empower you to reconcile and bless his people. Ash, receive this book as a sign of the authority which God has given you this day to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister his holy sacraments. As you receive this book as a sign of the authority which God has given you this day to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister his holy sacraments. Vanessa, receive this book as a sign of the authority which God has given you this day to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister his holy sacraments. Tracy, receive this book as a sign of the authority which God has given you this day to preach the gospel of Christ and to minister his holy sacraments.
God was in Christ reconciling the world to himself and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. We welcome you as ambassadors for Christ. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly.
It's very humble
for
you to come and do your thing. Please greet your new priest. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
nourish your people with the word of life and the bread of heaven.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks and praise through your Son, Jesus Christ, our great High Priest. He was lifted up for us on the cross, that he might reveal your glory and draw all people to himself. You exalted him to your right hand on high, and through your Holy Spirit, you sent upon your people a rich diversity of gifts. From this royal priestly people, you raise up ministers to proclaim your word, to care for your people, and to be the stewards of your holy mysteries. You call them to serve the world your Son redeemed, and build up his body, the Church, to be his bride. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in Christ. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in Christ.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness, granted by the power of your Holy Spirit. And according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me.
Christ is the bread of life.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, Lord Jesus, until you come in glory.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and cup, so that we, in the company of Michael, Gabriel, Raphael, all the angels and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father
in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our
that he died for you, and feed on in your hearts by faith, with thanksgiving. Lord God, Heavenly Father, grant to your church today the faith of her apostles, the hope of her martyrs, and the love of her Lord, our Saviour Jesus Christ.
Amen.
We thank you,
gracious Father, for welcoming your children to feast in your kingdom. By your love, unite us, and with your Spirit, send us. Amen.
May the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, equip you and strengthen you in your ministry.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you this day and always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Thank you. That's not still live streaming, is it?
No.
It says it's live.
Is it?
This is the national.
Yes.
Thank you.
It'll be quicker. Trust my sense of direction, Trace. This is quicker.
Women don't have a sense of direction.
No,
what's he
saying?
What's he saying? Is it definitely not?
Edward, I'll go out this door and
it's only quicker if this way.
Yes.
Locked.
No,
Trace is locked, so we'll go that way.
We have another choice.
Oh, and I should have gone to the loo. Never mind.
Do you want to?
No.
Thank you.